COVID-19 has upended our lives, transforming thriving cities into ghost towns, shuttering schools and business, emptying stadiums, and separating families. But in a sea of devastation, there is one island of normalcy.
Taiwan has several advantages, right? Like the healthcare, the ICT industry, the big data.
Taiwan's medical innovators draw on the country's renowned healthcare system and its world-class technological expertise. By merging these strengths, Taiwanese biomedical experts have created solutions for disease prediction.
针对血钾的异常，比医生准确判断的高出10%到20%左右。
Prevention.
We have successfully captured and removed the white blood cells.
Diagnosis.
IPMS 检测时间会是传统 PCR 的1/6。
And treatment.
能够自己顾自己，找回他自己的尊严。
These innovations will help the world combat chronic conditions, as well as humanity's latest scourge, COVID-19. It's just another day for Dr. Chun Bin Chan, a physician at the Infectious Disease Department of Taoyuan General Hospital. Dr. Chen has been treating COVID-19 patients since the start of the outbreak. Because of Taiwan's proximity to China, expectations were the island would be ravaged by COVID-19. But while the pandemic has spread rapidly around the world, causing tens of millions of cases and hundreds of thousands of deaths, Taiwan has managed to limit its total case count to a few hundred and its deaths to a mere handful. Dr. Chen and his team are on Taiwan's front lines combating the virus.
布里唐医院是在机场附近，所以我们比较会接受到比较多的机场直送的病人，是属于第一线的应变负责医院。Until
a cure or vaccine can be found, the best way to contain the virus is through efficient, reliable testing.
这次新冠肺炎能够做的筛检大概就有3个：抗原检验、抗体检验，还有核酸检验。那目前全球检验的标准还是以核酸检验的一个方式。
The gold standard for testing COVID-19 is PCR, short for polymerase chain reaction. Compared to antibody or antigen tests, PCR-based tests produce fewer false negatives. The process involves 3 main steps: sampling, nucleic acid extraction, and PCR diagnosis. But it has several drawbacks.
传统的一个核酸检验，平均需要4到5小时检验的机器的体积也可能比较大。Taiwan's
biomedical experts are betting that they can improve upon the testing method. Sitting outside Sin Ju McKay Memorial Hospital is a positive pressure COVID-19 testing booth made by Taiwan's Industrial Technology Research Institute, or ITRI. Created within weeks of the outbreak, this booth protects the medical staff from infection as they conduct the first step of PCR testing, the sampling. Dr. Wei Mo Chai has seen its advantages firsthand.
疫情一开始的时候，很多状况都不是很清楚。那我们是沿用就是直接面对面这样做一个裁剪。那当然，这个对医护人员来讲是感染的一个威胁。工研院的裁剪亭对医护人员是做一个很好的保护，它不会直接面对面的跟病患接触，不需要穿全套的隔离服，因为里面是正压，可以持续的工作很久一段时间。Once
a sample is collected, the second step is to extract its nucleic acid. Nucleic acid is the name for DNA and RNA. Unlike DNA's double helix structure formed by 2 strands, RNA only has a single strand. COVID-19 uses RNA as its genetic material inside its nucleus.
要提取核酸，那我们就需要有一个东西去跟核酸做一个结合，然后这样我们就可以把其他的杂质去除，剩下的东西就是核酸。
Dr. Lydia Kuo is a project manager at Zinnex Life Science. The molecular biology firm specializes in automated nucleic acid extraction. The process removes proteins and the membrane lipids to isolate the RNA for testing.
我们的专利它的设计上让我们可以比较有效的提取到比较高品质的那个核酸。
The final step.Is to test the extracted nucleic acid using polymerase chain reaction. Traditional PCR machines are large and slow, taking 3 to 4 hours to produce results. Over the last decade, ETRI has been developing a new PCR system that is small and quick. When COVID-19 hit, the Taiwanese government commissioned ETRI to adapt its PCR-based system to detect the virus.Dr. Peixin Zhang oversees this project.
我们之前就开发了一个小型化的分子检测系统，我们称它为 IPMS.
IPMX, the Intelligent Portable Molecular Diagnosis System, was originally designed to provide rapid flu tests at clinics, pharmacies, and homes.
因为空间也有限，我们第一个就是要把它做得小。
Using specialized substances known as reagents to transform the virus's extracted RNA into DNA, the machines use large modules to repeatedly heat and cool the DNA segment, triggering it to multiply and create millions of copies for a sufficient sample size. To drastically shrink the machine, the team made some game-changing modifications.
第一个突破点就是把它从传统的三段加温变成一个管子里面做热对流的方式来形成它需要的三个温度。
Like a lava lamp, the DNA segments in the thin tubes cycle through three temperatures of 40 to 60, 72, and 95 degrees Celsius.
在试管的下面给一个温度，然后让它跟上面造成有一个温差，病毒的核酸会做一个循环的动作，让它成功的复制讯号。
Dr. Ting Zhen Chen leads the hardware team to develop the miniature PCR machine. But shrinking the device is not enough. The team also needs to speed up the reagent reaction.
那中间是一个特殊的设计，能够有一个塑胶层的设计，让热对流的速度达到我们期望。
It took the ETRI team more than 7 years to design the hardware and reagents for their PCR system.As small as a can of soda and weighing about 600 grams, ETRI's IPMX is one of the world's smallest PCR machines. It's also super fast.
IPMX 的检测时间是传统 PCR 的六分之一。
By March 2020, the World Health Organization declared the COVID-19 outbreak a pandemic as it swept across the globe.Speedy, reliable tests were urgently needed to identify the virus and contain it. ETRI was ready.
PCR 试剂的成分就是聚合酶，但它最大的差异，比如说是辨别流感或辨别这次的新冠病毒，也就是要针对它们各自特定的基因去设计。
Dr. Jun Huang Liu's team developed two sets of reagents to test COVID-19 within a couple of months.
这个位置是我们要检测我们的检体是否采集正确的位置，那它应该是要正的。然后这两个位置的话是我们的第一组基因跟第二组基因的检测位置，那他们这两个位置如果是正的话，那表示这个病人就有被新冠病毒感染。这个是我们公立医院新开发的热对流检测系统，那我们今天可以拿来检测新冠病毒。
But does it work? Can speed and accuracy be coupled?
那我们萃取完检体之后，就可以跟试剂做混合。那试剂混合之后，我们可以装到我们的专用试管里面，这样可以让它在里面进行热对流。
Trials show over a 90% accuracy rate for COVID-19 testing, matching the accuracy of lab-sized machines. But the team is taking the testing system one step farther. They want to create a compact all-in-one system that incorporates the nucleic acid extraction process to protect frontline medical workers.
这个病毒的一个感染性很强，它很容易透过飞沫或接触方面就可以传染给其他人。
所以我们希望前处理的核酸萃取它是在一个密闭的装置以下被执行，这样对操作的人员不会有风险。
To speed up the R&D process, eTree collaborates with local biotech companies like Xenex Life Science. Dr. Lydia Kuo is tasked with creating an all-in-one system that meets eTree's requirements.
第一个就是它的体积要小，比较好移动。那第二部分就是时间的部分，那目标当然就是一个小时以内。首先样本会放在这个反应槽里面，那这是我们的核酸萃取的试剂。那上面这个部分呢，则是我们的那个自动手臂。那我们的自动手臂就会来提取它的耗材，然后开始进行核酸的萃取。萃取完的核酸，然后加入到工研院的 IPMX 里面，然后进行病毒核酸的检测反应。那以上整个运作完之后呢，就会又将结果传输到荧幕的部分，然后就会看到检测的结果。这个设备有机会在像是机场或者是边境全球所有需要的关卡，然后提供快速的核酸检测。
最近新冠的疫情还是不断的在发生，所以我们一直在 monitor 那个整个序列的发展，确保检测试剂可以适用在各个不同型的 type 上。
As COVID-19 continues to ravage the globe, scientists are racing against time to find solutions. Taiwan's innovations to create safe, low-cost, rapid, and reliable tests.Are giving the world both the hope and tools it needs to turn the tide and return to normalcy. Digital technology and progressive healthcare are credited for Taiwan's successful COVID-19 response. To experts, this comes as no surprise.
We have two world-class sectors. One is ICT, the other is healthcare.
Dr. Chi-Hui Wong, president of the Institute of Biotechnology and Medicine Industry, sees the very future of biotech in Taiwan's approach.
We have to bring together these two sectors to tell us what to do in the biotech industry. Biotech needs innovation, and it's to do with health. You need better technology to meet the ultimate goal, precision health.
The future of biotech is already here.In the realm of medical diagnosis, where Taiwanese innovation permits doctors to safeguard the lives of patients with chronic diseases by predicting negative outcomes before they occur. It's 8:30 in the morning. At Taipei's Tri-Service General Hospital, Tong Shung-sher's wife and daughter are getting him ready for his dialysis.Cher began receiving dialysis regularly 9 years ago when he developed an end-stage kidney disease due to diabetes.
那我每星期洗4次，所以我都在3.5小时左右。
Dialysis is used to remove waste, fluids, and extra chemicals from the blood in patients who lose kidney function. However, electrolyte imbalances are common among patients undergoing dialysis.Significantly raising their risk of sudden death.
那一天可以讲忽然间心跳很不舒服，那我看血氧机心跳从60跳50又破40 39，我赶快来急诊。我来的时候我就意识不太清醒，林教授就做了心电图跟验血。
Dr. Xie Hua Lin.A world-renowned nephrologist specializes in electrolyte imbalances.
电解质异常，特别是钾离子，会引起心律不整，那会导致突然的猝死。钾离子异常不是那么快就可以诊断出来，靠抽血，那实验的报告需要的时间大概约1小时。
For patients suffering from cardiac arrest, 1 hour may be too late.The Tri-Service General Hospital has deployed AI diagnostics to determine the cause of cardiac emergency.
那时候林教授从心电图就可以判读我血钾浓度有7.22多。
Instead of getting defibrillation at the ER to resuscitate the heart, Cher was ordered dialysis immediately. An hour later, the blood test revealed that the value of his potassium level upon arrival was a dangerously high 7.5 milliequivalent per liter. But by then, thanks to the dialysis treatment, Cher's condition had stabilized. Normally, the potassium level in the blood stays between 3.5 to 5.5 milliequivalent per liter. A patient suffering from dyskalemia will have a potassium level above or below the normal range. Hypokalemia is diagnosed when the value goes below 3.5, and hyperkalemia when the value exceeds 5.5.
2016年，我们就开始成立了我们用心电图来判断血钾的异常。
AI can be taught to quickly diagnose dyskalemia without waiting for a patient's blood results, simply by analyzing real-time ECG data. Dr. Qin Ling, an assistant professor at the National Defense Medical Center, trains the AI model to do the job.
我的工作主要是负责模型的训练。最开始的时候，我总共拿到了66000笔心电图及血钾这些资料。
Qin Ling feeds data to the AI model and guides it learning.
医师在这里面最重要的角色就是去建立大量的标注数据，如心电图以及它对应的血钾浓度，人工智慧就会自己去发掘它们两者之间的相关性。
Dr. Xie Huanglin keeps a detailed journal of his patients' lab tests. He and Qin Ling are amazed by the result.
依照目前我们反复的训练，针对血钾的异常，比医生能够准确判断的高出至少10%到20%左右。
The Tri-Service General Hospital's AI model is one of the first in the world to succeed.Because it holds a unique advantage over other hospitals.
严重低血钾跟严重高血钾的病患数非常的少。
But Dr. Xie Huanglin treats more than 2/3 of the patients with dyskalemia in Taiwan. This translates to richer data for the AI model.
我们现在的心电图总共有70万张以上，有血钾浓度的心电图，那至少也有20万张以上。
目前大概我们只要做了心电图，一上传，大概5秒钟就可以看到报告。
The cloud-based AI system analyzes patients' ECGs in real time and immediately alerts the health team when dyskalemia has been detected.
只要 AI 已经知道这是危险的，都可以透过简讯让临床的医师、护理师。主治医师、值班的都会知道。
The AI team hopes to expand the reach of the rapid detection system beyond the hospital.
未来的计划主要是希望先把人工智慧判读系统先跟消防局做合作，把它应用到全省的救护车上，让其他医院都可以使用到，从而提升台湾整体的医疗品质。
The demonstrated ability of the country's healthcare system to test and implement digital innovations explains why the future of biotech is already here in Taiwan. 15 million people suffer from strokes worldwide each year. It is a leading cause of death and disability. In Taiwan, strokes afflict 1 in every 12 people, with a staggering post-stroke disability rate of 61.2%. 70-year-old Bang Yolo from the east coast of Taiwan is one of the many coping with such a disability. Fortunately, a new treatment is on its way. It is 10 in the morning. Lo arrives at the hospital to start his 4th physical therapy session of the week. These mornings are a regular feature of Lo's life, ever since he suffered from his 2nd stroke in 2019.
我第一次中风的时候比较快好。我已经可以在外面自己在外面走一个多钟头。第二次比较严重，左边瘫痪，没办法走了。
The paralysis was devastating for Lo, who had been a passionate volunteer at a blood and bone marrow donation center ever since he retired.
以前全部人家捐水，我在做一些早物机动的工作，就要承担。骨髓关怀小组的核心。
Being wheelchair bound prevents him from doing the volunteer work that had given him a sense of purpose. He is willing to do anything just to walk again. Luckily for Lo, a revolutionary stem cell research team can offer hope.
右手举，哎，对，好，放。
The team is led by Dr. Xinrong Lin, a world-class neurosurgeon and the superintendent of Hualien Zhechi Hospital, the very hospital that runs the bone marrow donation center Lo once volunteered at.
脑中风是因为脑血管缺氧缺血，有一部分的神经细胞跟纤维在几个小时内就坏掉了，刚好影响到运动的话，它就一手一脚，它就没力了，就不会动了。半年以上没有恢复的话，大概就困难的。Low
stroke happened more than a year ago, way past the standard window of recovery, drastically limiting his chance of improvement. Seeing the daily mental and physical challenges his patients face is a constant inspiration for Dr. Lin, as he strives to find treatments to help them regain their old lives. Dr. Lin believes the answer may lie in stem cell treatment.
1989年，我们就成立做巴金森细胞移植这样子的一个研究团队。
He is one of the world's first doctors to perform a stem cell transplant to treat Parkinson's disease. And now, he is leading a clinical trial to extend the research to stroke patients. Stem cells have the unique ability to develop into specialized cell types in the body. By guiding that development, diseased or damaged tissue can be repaired. Bone marrow transplants have been used to treat leukemia because they contain hematopoietic stem cells, which regenerate blood cells. Dr. Lin has tried using hematopoietic stem cells to treat chronic stroke before, but the results were not ideal.
大部分病人可以站得起来，可以走路，他手呢，就进步就比较少，所以呢，我们觉得用自己的造血干细胞500万个会帮忙一些，但是能不能更好呢？比如说500万个变成1亿个。
He then shifted his attention to adipose-derived stem cells, which are isolated from fat tissue.
因为我们全身的脂肪是最多，而且干细胞也最多，取得也最容易，然后它的培养也快。
Dr. Lin is keen to see whether adipose-derived stem cells can repair the damaged brain tissue of stroke patients. The method has already passed animal trials, as well as phase 1 human clinical trials.Phase 2 is ready to begin. Lo is eager to be included in phase 2 of the trial.
希望是快点好起来，再做义工，自己能动会比较好一点呢。
太高，摸到下巴可以吗？
摸不到
哈。
这样子。
好 ，OK。
Before Lo can be admitted as a subject of the trial, he needs to go through a series of assessments.
中风我们怎么去量化，那它有一个国际的标准，就是 NIHSS， 它就是评量病人的认知能力、言语，还最重要是他的动作，这一方面来评分。分数在很稳定的范围之内，我们就会安排抽脂，要拿那个脂肪干细胞，整形外科它会在局部麻醉，从腹部、肚脐那附近拿大概5cc 脂肪。
Extraction is only the first step. For the stem cells to work, they must be cultured and propagated to a critical mass of over 100 million cells. For support, Dr. Lin looks to Taiwan's top biotech companies.
间质干细胞呢，它需要ADHD 需要无菌无尘室要来扩增，而且这个药呢是打到脑子里头，绝对是不能有任何感染。第二步，那个数量1亿，这个就牵涉到产业，不是说一家医院可以投入的，那个需要大家一起，共同来开发。
Guoxi Stem Cell, a biotech company in Hsinchu, has deep expertise in stem cell propagation. This is exactly what Dr. Lin was looking for.
那以我们自己本身实验室的经验来看，大概每1公克的脂肪组织。平均可以拿到10万个这个干细胞，那我们培养2周的时间内，
就可以增加到1000倍，差不多是有1亿个这个干细胞的数量。
First, the biotech team must achieve a critical mass of stem cells from a small sample size. Then, the surgical team must find a way to safely inject the cells directly into Lo's brain.
我们就局部麻醉开一个小小洞而已，是一个非常精准的一个手术。
How will the medical team perform the injection without further harming Lo's already damaged brain? Taiwan's doctors and biotech experts are working together to develop a pioneering stem cell therapy for patients suffering from chronic stroke complications. Since 2015, neurosurgeon Dr. Shin Rong Lin of Tzu Chi Hospital in eastern Taiwan has been working with Dr. Po Chen Lin, the CTO at Guoxi Stem Cell, on a solution. Once the patient's sample reaches the lab, it is under Dr. Po Chen Lin's jurisdiction.
第一关就是检查说脂肪组织的运送过程有没有符合我们的要求。接着当天就会开始进行组织的分离，透过剪切跟酵素分解的方式取出我们要的干细胞。
The 5 cc of fat extracted from Lo contains about 500,000 stem cells, which is not a lot for treatment purposes. So Guoxi cultures the stem cells.
细胞需要一些生理调控机制来帮助细胞往正确的方向去持续的生长。根据不同的适应症，我们去搭配出不同培养基的配方，治疗脑中风，它就需要一些脑神经的滋养物质的表现。跟抗发炎因子的表达，才可以有比较好的疗效。调和之后装到这个药品里面，那来完成这个制剂的阶段。
那这时候呢，病人再住院，准备来做细胞的植入。
Back at the Tzu Chi Hospital, Lo is checking in to prepare for his surgery. Throughout the process, his daughter stands by his side for moral support.The doctors and nurses are placing a stereotactic head frame on Lo to provide reference points for the operation.
我们会做病人的核磁共振摄影，可以看到他神经细胞坏掉的地方，去精准定位到我们要植入的地方。
This imaging software allows them to calculate the exact stem cell injection points in three dimensions.
我们在电脑算好以后呢，我们有可以换 X、Y、Z 轴，利用立体定位哪一个空间，我们非常精准的会把移植的目标那个针头摆在那里，
控制它运动的地方啊，这附近坏掉了哈，中风啊，这它的外侧啊，再打一点，然后照它最底侧的地方，最底侧的地方，底侧中风的底侧的地方。我们就打一点啊，所以我们希望他的神经哈能够这里再长回来，这里长回来，这里也长回来，来控制他的手脚。
After Dr. Lin and his team have designated the injection points, they proceed to the operation room to begin the surgery. The stem cell treatment is scheduled to arrive during the operation, so that the cells are in their most active and potent state.
脑内移植呢，我们就局部麻醉开一个小小洞而已，细细的针把1亿个干细胞把它送进去，对脑神经外科而言算是微侵害，但是是一个非常精准的一个手术，就慢慢把3000万个干细胞呢打在那附近啊，然后第一针打完了，还有第二针，还有第三针啊，那大概过程呢可能差不多45分钟或一个小时哈，那就可以完成。
Once the surgery is completed, Lo goes through a brain scan to ensure everything went according to plan. The surgery was a success. Now the stem cells will be given time to regenerate and repair the damaged tissue in Lo's brain. Lo is just beginning his road to recovery, but the patients from the previous trial are already seeing improvement. Ms. Sakura Lin was one of the three patients in the phase one trial.After experiencing a stroke in 2014, she became paralyzed on the right side of her body. In addition to paralysis, the stroke caused aphasia, which made it extremely difficult for her to speak.
我早上起来的时候，我就是抱不起来。我说话，我儿子就说：“你在讲什么？我听不懂这样啊。”
Since receiving the stem cell transplant a couple of years ago, her condition has drastically improved.
我就这样一直摆脚，慢慢走路，一直走路，我越来越会走路。
进步啊！
有
进步哪里？
进步家里。
家里。
因为阿嬷呢，她走路是进步很快哦，越走路越顺越好哦。那她手呢也有一些进步，本来提不起来哦，她就可以抬得起来。
那第一阶段的病人，他在整个运动还有神经的功能上面都有明显的一个进步。那这也让我们在第二阶段的人体临床试验上面更有信心。
Miss Lin's encouraging results have given Lo hope.
神经的再生能够让它的功能更好一点，所以细胞跟旁边的神经一定要互动。那目前呢，就是做各种的复健，让旁边的神经又能够活化起来，它的回路就越快，修复的就越快。
Lo is doing physical therapy multiple times a week to stimulate nerve growth. He looks forward to the day he can walk again.And devote himself once more to volunteer work.
东方不要太担心，会慢慢变好。
我们希望透过干细胞的移植呢，让他能够又再站起来，能够自己顾自己，找回他自己的尊严。这个就是我们努力的目标。
Dr. Lin is hopeful that this groundbreaking stem cell research will rehabilitate stroke victims and return them to the vibrancy of their past.In 2020, there were about 118.4 million blood donations made worldwide for those in need. To ensure safety and prevent blood transfusion complications, Taiwan's biomedical experts take extreme lengths to create innovative technology to care for the most vulnerable. Inside a hospital in central Taiwan, a patient is getting ready for a blood transfusion.For 25-year-old artist and gallery owner Jia Mei Li, this is a procedure she has been receiving for as long as she can recall.
在一岁四个月的时候就高烧不断，最后诊断出来是重度的地中海型贫血。
Thalassemia is an inherited disorder that results in a low level of red blood cells in the body. Li needs regular blood transfusions to stay alive.
我的输血时间大概一个月一次，总共是输1000cc。
Both she and the nurses look well-practiced and at ease. But even a common procedure like this entails life-threatening risks.
2018年的时候，我产生了非常严重的输血反应。那时候是整个是心跳加速，眼睛红肿，然后无法呼吸，全身发高烧。然后妈妈就说：“哎，不行，要赶快来送急诊。”那时候我已经进入昏迷的状态。那时候真的就是会有一个画面出来，然后你会走到一个隧道，那前面有一个光一直指引你往前进。医生一次打了7-8支的抗过敏针，才把我拉回来。
Transfusion reactions like the one Li experienced occur in 8 of every 1,000 transfusions, and they can be fatal.
当时输血这一块是非常日常的事情，那也不会想说，哎，原来真的是每一次输血都跟死亡这么接近。
输血反应最常见的就是输血引起的发烧，还有像输血引起的肺部水肿、急性肺伤害，林林总总大概不下20种。
Dr. Fang Ye Chu, the president of Taiwan Society of Blood Transfusion.Is responsible for educating medical professionals on the best practices in blood transfusion.
我们很多的副作用都来自于白血球，它有免疫功能，它会放出很多细胞激素，引起我们全身的发炎反应。
Leukocytes, commonly known as white blood cells, are one of the chief triggers of transfusion reactions.
病人是缺乏红血球携带氧气，血小板。那是血浆的凝固因子，白血球不是我们要输给病人用的，我们可以使用所谓减白血品，把白血球去除掉，就可以去除掉在血袋中残存的白血球所造成的副作用。
Many countries have begun to use leukocyte-reduced blood to minimize the risk to recipients.
1989年，那时候我在美国，是我第一次看到，血库在使用减白过滤器，我非常好奇。那个时候因为是一个专利，所以没有人知道它的机转，所以这个问题一直存在我的心里。
Dr. Shin Jong Ho, a hematologist at the McKay Memorial Hospital in Taipei.Is aware of the technical challenges of leukocyte reduction. Unlike other blood components that can be separated using a centrifuge, leukocyte reduction filters are the only way to remove white blood cells in the blood. Only 3 to 4 countries in the world have successfully developed leukocyte reduction devices, and they are costly and time-consuming. Dr. Shin Jong Ho wondered if Taiwan could do better.
10年前我认识的中研大学化工系的教授张庸博士，那他的这个薄膜技术呢，是用在工业领域方面。我那时候就在想，是不是可以应用在医疗领域呢
？Membrane actually is the medium that can separate the compounds, and we can flow the wanted compound through the membranes and stop the compound we don't want.
Membrane technology is commonly used in everyday life.From medical masks to water treatment.
And we also can apply the membrane technology in cell suppression and blood filtration.
Dr. Ho and Professor Cham joined forces to develop leukoreduction filters, but they did not foresee the challenges ahead of them. To gain international certification, the procedure must meet a strict standard of leukocyte reduction.
一袋500毫升的全血，含有白血球的量大约是5×10^9次方。把这一袋的白血球减量到5×10^6次方，这样就达到了美国 FDA 的标准。
It takes about 20 to 30 minutes to filter each bag of blood. Due to the nature of leukocytes, developing leukocytes capture technology poses a unique challenge.
Because leukocytes are easily deformed, they cannot be separated using only a pore size of the membranes. Secondly, on average, you only can find one leukocyte in 1,000 red blood cells. So it's very difficult to really screen it. We need to find a method to specifically capture leukocytes.
Based on his research on bio-inspired interfaces and membranes,Dr. Cham founded PuriBlood to develop leukocyte reduction technology, which he named Zwitter Ionic Bias Surface Coating, ZISC for short.
This technology can be used to modify membranes with two different molecular structure domains on the membrane surface.
ZISC 这个技术，我们称为双离子抗粘连，它是同时带有正电跟负电的一种化学结构。
Dr. Chang's former doctoral student, Ken Jong, is the VP of R&D at PuriBlood.
Through the control of charge balance, we have found the best ratio, and that can specifically capture white blood cells.
It took the team years of research to devise the technology to capture leukocytes. But developing a prototype is one thing, mass production is quite another.
It's actually used in industry, it has to be cost.
Membrane scientists Dr. Yung Chong and his team have found a leukocyte reduction technology that can make blood transfusions safer. The big question now is, can it be mass-produced?
原始的量产技术它的 cost 太高，它实际要用在工业上面，它是必须要考量成本。
Instead of manufacturing intricate ZISC membranes using melted polymer fibers, the team decides to coat the fabric with a ZISC solution.
我们决定把原料做成像油漆一样，它可以直接涂抹在薄膜上面，然后可以很稳定的附着在上面。
After nearly a decade of intensive research and development, the ZISC technology is finally ready for the market. This revolutionary invention not only captures leukocytes, but provides higher red blood cell recovery rates and cuts the filtration time by 2/3.At the PuriBlood headquarters in northern Taiwan, an assembly line has been set up for production.
我们将薄膜用浸泡的方式，经过含浸槽，让这些涂料均匀的散布在薄膜当中。含浸槽体 出来之后，然后简单的进行干燥。
Then onto an intricate membrane layering process where the rolls of membrane are combined. Each filter is composed of 70 layers of membrane. First, two rolls are combined into one. Then the dual layered rolls are placed on a machine that presses all of them into a single roll of film.
再一起拉到所谓的熔切机，是利用超音波切割的方式去切成一块一块的薄膜，我们称为膜片。
This is the heart of the Luco reduction filter.
最后进入到了所谓的 housing 的阶段，我们有制作一些特殊的 PC 材质的外壳，然后去进行组装。
The core ZISC filter is then assembled with other components to create the complete Luco reduction device.
第一个就是所谓的插入针，那插入针就是连接血袋跟解埋过滤器。这袋血大概330到350cc， 然后过滤完之后大约会在320左右的过滤量，这个过滤器里面可能会残留大约20到30毫升左右的血液。这个叫做血块过滤器，它主要是避免比较大的血块进入到解埋过滤器里面，然后产生堵塞的现象。我可以看到那个血液开始从膜开始透过，我从这边进去到整个过滤器的下半部，然后经过减白之后呢，这个血液就会经过这个管路进入到转移带，过滤完了之后，转移带会直接从管路这端截断，再把整个血带拿去储存。
The cutting-edge ZISC technology enables the Puri blood filter to capture leukocytes, while its anticoagulation property allows other blood components to pass through quickly. It takes about 7 minutes to filter a 350cc unit of red blood, making it the world's fastest leukoreduction filter.
We have successfully captured and removed 99.9% of fibroid cells.Compared to traditional centrifugation methods, ZISC technology can improve the removal rate and operation efficiency of white blood cells.
捐血中心是每年都会去更新他们的医疗器材，医疗上可以多增加的防护，那我们就可以多增加，不然出差错是有生命危险的。
Luco reduction filters could minimize the risk for those like Lee who need blood transfusions.Lee can go on with her life, creating art and running a gallery for handicapped artists, knowing that she is in good hands. But PuriBlood is not yet satisfied. Its next objective is real-time leukoreduction filters, something the world has never seen before.
在捐血过程中，血从手肘这里的血管出来，就在这管线上呢，放置一个 real-time 即时的减白过滤器。这样的话，白血球根本没有机会进入血袋，那这样的减白效果应该会更好。
Out of challenges and crises can emerge new and incredible outcomes when the best minds join forces. Pandemics like COVID-19 have written some of the darkest chapters in human history.But with intelligence and compassion, humanity can prevail. Keeping themselves nimble and flexible, Taiwan's scientists, engineers, and medical professionals are disrupting conventions, creating ingenious solutions, and rethinking healthcare to protect and preserve our well-being. Their labor of love not only helps us survive, but more importantly, thrive.